बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम साहिब नूर एंड वेलकम टू अ न्यू लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्ड थ्योरी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 5 ऑफ द कोर्स एंड वी विल स्टडी टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर 2। द टाइटल नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज वेक्टर एनालिसिस। और मेन टॉपिक्स ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आर टू स्टडी द कोऑर्डिनेट कन्वर्जन in which we will convert the coordinate of a cylindrical system to Cartesian coordinate system or spherical coordinate to the Cartesian coordinate system, and we'll also study the reverse process in which the Cartesian coordinate can be converted into spherical or cylindrical coordinate system. Remember that the laws of electromagnetism are invariant under these coordinate system, but if a symmetry of a problem is related to a specific coordinate system, then it is convenient to solve them in that specific coordinates. Our last topic will be to study an example in which we will see that if a problem which is related to a specific coordinate symmetry, and if we solve it by other coordinates, then it will be a little difficult. Let's start our first topic, the conversion of a cylindrical coordinate to Cartesian coordinates. Consider a vector whose coordinate has been given into the cylindrical coordinates, which are r, phi, z, and we will find the expression for the same vector into Cartesian coordinates, which are x, y, z. The z is the common axis between cylindrical and Cartesian coordinate system. So, first we write the expression of vector A in the Cartesian coordinates. If a vector A has three components, so in Cartesian coordinate it can be written as AX, AX plus AY, AY plus AZ, AZ. And the same vector in the cylindrical coordinate can be written as AR, AR plus AFI, AFI plus AZ, and AZ. The small a's represent the unit vectors in the corresponding systems. Now, we take the scalar product or the dot product of AX, the base unit vector along x-axis in the Cartesian coordinates, with these two vectors. So, now we will take the dot product of AX with this expression and this expression. So, we will multiply AX in dot operation with first equation. We will get A dot AX from the left hand side, and for the right hand side we have only AX, because when we multiply AX in dot operation with AY, the resultant is 0, and again if we multiply AX with AZ in dot operation, the result is 0. So, the above expression, the right hand side give us only AX. Now, we multiply again AX with the second equation. So, the left hand side will give us the same result, that is A dot AX, and the right hand side is equal to AR dot AX into AR plus AFI dot AX into AFI, and the AZ dot AX equal to 0. So, the third term is vanished. We have only two terms on the right hand side of second expression. Now, if we looked at the left hand side of this equation equal to the left hand side of this equation. So, the right hand side of these equation will equal, and the right hand side of these equations are AX equal to AR dot AX into AR plus AFI dot AX into AFI. Now, we will find the coefficient of AR and AFI, which are in term of the dot product of base unit vectors in two coordinates. For this, we consider a cylinder which has been put on the three axes of the Cartesian coordinate. in such a way that the central axis of the cylinder lies along with the x-axis, and the origin of the cylinder is coincided with the origin of the Cartesian coordinates. And the downward arrow, the blue arrow representing the x-axis, and the rightward horizontal arrow representing the y-axis. And we put the cylinder in such a way that the bottom surface lies on the xy plane, and this green vector represent the radius of the cylinder, and the radius of the cylinder is taken as r, and this radial vector makes an angle phi, which is known as the plane angle, with the x-axis. This angle is made by vector r with the x-axis. Now we have their corresponding unit vectors. As the x-axis is vertically downward, so from this point, from the surface of the cylinder where the radial vector ends, from this point we draw a downward vector which representing the direction of x-axis, or simply ax. And perpendicular to ax we have a vector which is ay, and the radial vector is taken as ar, representing by this red vector. And perpendicular to ar we have a vector which is represented by a phi. This is the direction in which the angle varies. And now we can also observe that the angle between AX and AR is the same as the angle between x-axis and R. So this green angle representing the angle between AX and AR, which is equal to phi, and this angle is less than 90. The purple angle, which is the angle between AX and A phi, must be greater than 90, because the angle between AX and AY is 90, and this purple angle is greater than 90. It covers the angle between AX and AY, also the angle between Y and A phi. So this angle, the purple color angle, is greater than 90, while the green angle is less than 90. And now this dot operation can be opened by the formula of dot products. So as we have observed that the green angle is less than 90, which is phi, and the purple angle, which is greater than 90 and equal to 90 plus phi. Now to find that what are the values of AR dot AX and A phi dot AX, we will open the dot products, which is simply equal to magnitude of AR multiply magnitude of AX into cos angle between them, and the angle between AR and AX is phi, and the magnitude of unit vector is always equal to 1. So AR dot AX is simply equal to cos phi, and the angle between A phi and AX is greater than 90, which is equal to phi plus 90. And if we open this trigonometric identity, we will have minus sine phi. And the expression for AX, which are AR dot AX into AR plus A phi dot AX into A phi. So we will put the value of AR dot AX, which is cos phi, and the value of A phi minus A phi dot AX, which is equal to minus sine phi. So the expression for AX is equal to cos phi AR minus sine phi into A phi. So at the right hand side we have components of a vector A in the cylindrical coordinates, and in the left hand side we have component of vector A in the Cartesian coordinates. Now we can obtain a similar expression, that when we multiply AY in dot operation with the expression of vector A, which has been taken in the cylindrical coordinate as well as in the Cartesian coordinate. If we multiply and perform the same process, we will have an expression for Ay which is equal to sin phi Ar plus cos phi A phi. The z component is a common coordinates in these coordinate system, and a matrix form the above expression can be written as Ax, Ay, Az, which are the components of vector A in the Cartesian coordinates, is equal to matrix in which cos phi minus sin phi 0, sin phi cos phi 0, 0, 0, 1. These are the coefficient of Ar, A phi and A z. So, A z is a common components between cylindrical coordinate and Cartesian coordinate of a vector A. This matrix is also called as the orthogonal matrix or the transformation matrix between cylindrical coordinate and Cartesian coordinates. The determinant of this matrix is equal to 1. As we find out the expression for Ax and Ay, which are the Cartesian components of vector A, and these expressions still contain phi and the radial term. So, for this we use the trigonometric relation between x and r. So, from figure, r which makes an angle phi with x axis. So, the component of r which lies on the x axis equal to r cos phi, and the component of r which lies on the vertical axis or on the y axis equal to r sin phi. So, x is equal to r cos phi and y is equal to r sin phi, and as z is the common component, so for z we have to write z. Now, if we want to convert a coordinates of a vector from Cartesian to cylindrical coordinates, we will use the following relation. R will equal to square root of x square plus y square is the bottom plane of the cylinder lies in xy plane. So, it will make a circle on xy. The second component of the cylinder, which is phi, and in term of a Cartesian coordinate, it can be written as tangent inverse y by x, or simply the perpendicular component by the horizontal components, and z is the common coordinates in these systems. Also, if you want to find the value of cos phi, so from this equation x is equal to r cos phi. For cos phi we can write x divided by r, and this is the value of r. And similarly, the value of sin, which is equal to y divided by r, and for r we write under the root x square plus y square. So, here we have studied that we can convert a Cartesian coordinates into cylindrical coordinates as well. Now, in this slide we will convert a vector from a cylindrical coordinate to Cartesian coordinates. The given vector in the cylindrical coordinate is A, which is equal to AR 3 cos phi minus A phi into 2R plus AZ into 5. And if we compare this expression with the general expression of vector A in the cylindrical coordinate, which is equal to AR, AR plus AFI, AFI plus AZ, AZ, and follow the 1-1 correspondence rule, we will have the value of AR equals to 3 cos phi, the value of AFI is equal to minus 2r and the value of az is equal to 5. And the transformation equation between cylindrical coordinates and Cartesian coordinates in matrix form is given by ax, fi, az, this side of the equation representing the Cartesian component of vector A, and this column vector representing the component of vector A in the cylindrical coordinate. This matrix is known as the transformation matrix or the orthogonal matrix, and as Z component is a common component between cylindrical coordinate and in Cartesian coordinates. So if we put the value of AR, AFI and AZ, we will have this expression, and now we will multiply each component, the first row with this column matrix, then second row with this column matrix, and third row with this column matrix, and we'll have the expression for vector A like AX 3 cos square phi plus 2R sin phi plus AY 3 sin phi cos phi minus 2R cos phi plus AZ 5. This expression comes after the matrix multiplication, and the coefficient of AX, AY and AZ, which are the base vector in the Cartesian coordinate, still has phi and r component of the cylindrical coordinates. To remove phi and r, we will use the following expression, in which the cos phi equals to x by r, but for r we will put r square, x square plus y square under the root, and for sin phi we will use y divided by r, and the value of r is x square plus y square. Now our final expression for vector A, after putting the values of cos phi and sin phi, r, putting the value of r, we will have A equal to ax into 2x square divided by x square plus y square plus 2y plus ay into 3xy divided by x square plus y square minus 2x plus az into 5. So now this expression is a pure expression for vector A in the Cartesian coordinates. Now in next example we will solve the line integral by two methods, in which the expression will be given in the Cartesian coordinates, and we will solve them, the line integral in the Cartesian coordinate as well as in the cylindrical coordinate. But we will have to solve this expression or the line integral from A to B, which is the quarter cycle with a radius r is equal to 3, and we will solve this line integral into two coordinates. First we will solve it in the Cartesian coordinate system, and then we'll solve it into the cylindrical coordinate system. But to solve it in the cylindrical coordinate system, first we will convert this expression into cylindrical coordinates, and then we'll write the length element in the cylindrical coordinate as well. So the line integral from A to B is simply the dot product of a force into the length element. So the force is given, so we will choose the length element from A to B in such a way that the two parameters x and y varies. This will be in the Cartesian coordinates, and for cylindrical coordinate dl will be in form of r phi z. So we will solve the line integral into the rectangular as well as in the cylindrical coordinates. For rectangular coordinates we use the length element, which equal to ax dx plus ay dy. The third component is taken as 0, because for the given circle the z is equal to 0, so dz will also equal to 0. So the length elements will contain only x and y parameters. And its radius for the given portion of a circle is 3, so the equation of a circle can be written as x square plus y square equal to 9. And we will integrate the f dot dl expression, and the dot product of f and dl is equal to xy dx minus 2x dy. So this expression contains two terms, and we will integrate each term from a to b. And the first expression contain xy parameter, and the integral will be with respect to x, so we will eliminate y using the above equation, which is x square plus y square equal to 9. So the value of y from this expression can be written as 9 minus x square under the root. And putting the value of y, or eliminating the y term, this expression will be explicit equation of x. And similarly, we can eliminate x in the next term, and then we'll integrate from a to b with respect to y. The first integral will be integrated with respect to x, and the value of x at a is equal to 3, and the value of x at b is equal to 0. So the first integral will be from 3 to 0, and the second integral at a y is equal to 0, and at b y is equal to 3. After integration, we will get minus 9 into 1 plus pi by 2. The same line integral can be solved in the cylindrical coordinate. We will use the length element as a phi r d phi, because the radial term and the z term are fixed, so their differential part will be equal to 0. And dl is equal to a phi 3 into d phi, as r is equal to 3. And we will integrate this integral from 0 to pi by 2. And we will also convert f into the cylindrical coordinate, because f is given in the Cartesian coordinate. So for x we will put our cos theta or cos phi, and for x we will put our cos phi, and for y we will put our sin phi in the expression of f, and then we'll evaluate the integral from a to b with respect to phi parameter. After integration, we will get minus 9 into 1 plus pi by 2. The value of this integral is the same which we have obtained in the Cartesian coordinate. By comparing these integral, you will see that the line integral in the rectangle coordinate is a little complicated than the line integral in the cylindrical coordinate. So if the symmetry of the problem is related with the cylindrical coordinate, then it is more convenient to solve the problem in the cylindrical coordinate rather it to solve in the rectangular coordinates. Now we have to study the conversion of spherical coordinate into Cartesian coordinate. In the adjacent figure, three mutually perpendicular axes, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, are coincided at a point called the origin, and we have a point in a space represented by P, and which is r distance away from the origin. This position vector, or this vector, makes an angle theta with the z axis, so the adjacent side of this theta is equal to r cos theta, and the perpendicular side of this figure is representing r sin theta. And the projection of this r sin theta lies on the xy plane. So this is r sin theta. This vector, this side is equal to this side, and the value of this vector will be r sin theta. Now this is the radial vector of the plane. So the component of this vector on the x-axis will be equal to r sine theta cos phi, and the value of this vector along the y-axis will be equal to r sine theta sine phi. So, we have to convert a vector whose components are given in the spherical coordinate. The spherical coordinates are r theta phi, in which r is the radial vector, theta is half angle parameter, and the phi is the plane angle, and we will convert them into x, y, z. So, the transformation equation r, x will be equal to r sine theta cos phi, y will be equal to r sine theta sine phi, and z is equal to r cos theta. And we can converse the process as well, in which the Cartesian coordinates will be given and we will convert them into the spherical coordinate. So, for r we will write x square plus y square plus z square. For theta we will write tangent inverse under the root x square plus y square divided by z, and for plane angle we will write tangent inverse y by x. So, here we have an example in which a spherical coordinates can be converted into Cartesian or cylindrical coordinates. So, the spherical coordinate in which r is equal to 8, the half angle is equal to 120 degree, and phi, which is the plane angle, equal to 330 degree. For rectangular coordinates, we will use x is equal to r sine theta cos phi. The value of r is 8, the value of theta is 120, the value of phi is 330. So, our x component of the Cartesian coordinate or x component of the rectangular coordinate will thus equal to 6. The y value of the rectangular coordinate will be equal to r sine theta sine phi. Putting the value, we will get minus 2 under the root 3. The value of z, which equal to r cos theta, and putting the value of r and theta, we will have the value of z will be equal to minus 4. And so, the set of the components will be equal to 6 minus 2 under the root 3 and minus 4. The value of cylindrical coordinate from spherical coordinate can be obtained by using the following expressions. R is equal to r cos theta. The small r representing the radius of the cylinder, while the capital R represent the radius of a spherical surface. So, the radius of the spherical surface is 8 and theta is equal to 120, and there is a common parameter between cylindrical and spherical coordinates, which is phi. So, phi will be equal to 330. And the value of z will be equal to r sine theta. So, the value of r is 8 and the value of theta is 120. Putting the value, you can obtain the value of z, which will be equal to minus 4. And this is the common parameter between cylindrical and Cartesian coordinates. So, let's summarize lecture number 5. What we have studied in this lecture? We studied the process of a coordinate conversion, and we convert cylindrical coordinate into Cartesian coordinates or a spherical coordinate into Cartesian coordinates, and we can also do the reverse process, in which the Cartesian coordinate can be converted into spherical or into rectangular coordinate as well. We have also solved a line integral by using the cylindrical and Cartesian coordinates. In next lecture, we will study the surface and volume integral, and then we will study the gradient of a scalar field and divergence of a vector function. I hope that you will understand this lecture. If you have any question, you can contact me at my email. Thanks, and Allah Hafiz.